अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ सेकंड लेक्चर अबाउट द टेबल. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द टेबल टू टेबल इंसर्ट एंड देयर आर द डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ इंसर्टिंग द टेबल देयर. इन दिस टेबल, दिस लेक्चर वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग दैट प्रोसेस. हियर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टूल, अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज, अबाउट इंसर्शन, डिलीशन एंड मर्जिंग ऑफ द सेल्स एंड द रोज एंड द कॉलम्स. ओके, watch the video from zero to end, then you can to learn thoroughly. Okay, we insert a new page. There is insert table. We insert any table here. For example, this is our table. We write here name, address, phone, and class. This is the table that we have created for the temporary practice. When you click in the table, you will feel, you will watch here table tools. Just click in the table, it will appear in the table tool. When you click on the blank space, there is nothing. Just click in the table. First of all, we're going to do about the layout. In layout, there are lot of commands, lot of options. First of all, I am in address column. Okay, in address column, just click your mouse and there are the row and column insertion and deletion. Just click here, insert above. Insert above means a row will insert on the above side of the current location. Just click here, again click, again click, again click. Mean the row is going to insert on the above side of the Lahore. When you will click on Karachi, insert below, click here, insert left, click here, insert right. Mean you can insert rows and columns any on any location from any stage. Again undo, just click this, go back in the history. If you want to insert more than two columns, select the two columns, select the three columns and click insert left. Three columns will insert on the left side. Select the two rows, insert, click insert above, it will insert two more rows on above side. If you select these two rows, insert below, it will insert two more rows on below side. Okay, now I select the two rows, there is deletion, delete row. Just click the mouse here, delete column. Just click here, delete cell and shift cell. Shift cell up, one cell will move on upside. Delete table, it will delete the total table. Okay students, this is relevant to insertion and deletion of the columns and rows. Now I want to insert a heading on the top of the row, on top of the column. Insert above and select the first row with the mouse. And there is the option merge cells. Merge cell. Merge cell will make a single cell of this four cells. Click on the center and you can write the heading in the center. Okay. Just click here and click here. You want to insert more column in this. Insert left. Want to divide into two, split cells into three columns. It will divide into threes. Divide this box into more two. This is split. And if you merge these, this is merge cells. You can also split the table from this location. Click here, split table. It will divide into two parts. This is insertion, deletion and merging of the tables. Let's try another thing. In last lecture, we insert a manual table, that is draw table. In draw table, as you know, it's a manual. Perfection is not possible in this. For example, I have inserted different columns and different rows. In this table, neither rows nor columns are equal to each other. Press escape button. Now I have three commands. In layout, there is a autofit or distribute rows, distribute column. Distribute rows mean it will divide, it will distribute the columns into same space. Just click on the distribute row, click on any location of the table, click on the distribute rows. You will feel that all the rows height is same now. Just click here, distribute columns. Now the columns are of same size. When you click, when you type here 1, 2, 3, okay, just do it zoom, just select this one. It's a text direction. You can change the direction of the text. It's a alignment. Where you want to be as per your cell size. Now I'm typing here. Class, roll number, address, blood, NAC, room. Just click here. First of all, it's necessary to know about the information that this text is basically known as the information, your content. Just click here. Auto fit to contents mean your cell width, column width will be as per content size. Auto fit to window, auto fit to contents. When you are typing here address, Lahore, Pakistan, now you are feeling that your column width is increasing gradually as per text size. If you want to fix the size of this column, just click here, fix column width. Now it will not allow the table that to increase the cell or column size as per text increase. It will wrap in second line. Automatically it will wrap in second line. Okay. Again we click on the auto fit to contents and auto fit to window. This is your table. And student, in this table the height of the rows is too small. You can increase from here. Just select the row, increase from here. Again select, decrease from here. Just select. If you want to increase or decrease the column width, but it's compulsory for you that to select whole the column. If you will not select whole the column, then selected cell may reduce or decrease. It's my suggestion that to select whole the column or whole the row. Okay. There is another very important command that I'm going to tell you now, that is header row repeat. It's disabled now. I'm going to delete this table. Now this is my current table. I am writing here to temporary text. Just select the heading and change its shading color. Any color that you choose. Okay. Now I am selecting these three lines. Just copy it and paste to increase the data. I am pasting it on multiple pages and try to zoom it and watch your tables that your heading is only in first table. it's not on second or third table. Just like this. If I do it in maroon color and text in white color. Okay, this is my table. Now my requirement is just to repeat the heading row on the top of every page. Just select this, go in table, layout, just click on this option, header row repeat. When you click on this, it will repeat your same heading on this table, on this page, on third and fourth. Automatically it will display on every page. But it's compulsory for you that you understand that you cannot change the text of the headings whilst you are sitting on other pages. Always you have to move on the first page for changing the text, for changing the heading, color or any property there. Okay? There is another table before me. Here I have written something. Just click here, layout, convert to text, and tap OK. Now this text is converted into text. Table lines are erased. Insert, table, convert text to table. Again, we are converting text into table. Okay, this was that. Here is a little command about the little formula that we apply here. Just type here 44, 43, 54. And 65, 85. I want to get the total of this line in this cell. Just click here. There is a formula tab. Formula cap command. Click here. It's an option to do little sum or anything else in Word other than Excel. Automatically you get the command. Is equal to sum above. Just click here. You are getting your total. If there is some another command values formula, there is equal to sum left. And you are getting total of that from left side. This total is from the top side. Okay. Now guys, just select this. Go to design, borders. You are going to press no border. There is no line here. Just click on the table. There is option view grid lines. Just click here. When you click on the view grid line, it will give you dotted lines that will give you assistance for working in this environment. But these lines are non-printable. View grid lines. Okay. There is another property option. In property, you can wrap the tables. For example, what is this? Just type here a few text is equal to rand. I have few text. Just click here, insert table. This is my table. Write some text here. In table, go to auto fit to contents. Now you have a shrink table. Now you want to wrap your text around your table. Okay. Select the table. Table properties. There is option of alignment. You want the table on the left side or the right side. There is by default on left side. But text wrapping already is selected none. But I'm going to click on the around. Just press OK in the dialog box. Your text will wrap in the round of this table. Again click here. Properties. You want in the center. Properties. You want on the right side. This is wrapping of the text. Now you can move your table anywhere with the help of this option. It's very interesting for the students that understand about the table properties. I think you can do that now. And this is already you have done, I think, just to change the colors of the tables, shading, top, draw table, erase table. Thank you very much, dear. And repeat it again. And first of all, you should try to learn or listen the lectures of 1, 2, 3, 4, and I think 5. Okay, thank you very much.